That's a Honda CBR650r. Brand new, all red, blazing. So there are the newly designed LED headlamps. They look quite menacing. This is a beauty, a looker. If you look from the front, it's quite neatly designed. Then you have these Nissan brake calipers, similar to what I have on my Versys 650. Pretty good, all heated up. Those are the four pipes hidden through quite neatly, and the golden color on them looks quite neat. Then you have these Showa suspension on the front, which is non-adjustable, but it provides a great ride quality. The suspension is pretty good. There is inline 4 650cc engine, very neatly designed. The brownish tints that they have given to this whole engine looks pretty neat. Then you have the adjustable rear suspension and the Two Brothers exhaust. Of course, this is an add-on to this test ride motorcycle to enhance the feel and lure more buyers in. Then you have this rear disc brake with the Nissan brake calipers again. If you look from the back side, the motorcycle has a, just from the right side, the motorcycle has this Dominar-ish feel to it. Nothing very fancy, or it does not have this distinct identity that you can spot it from the back that a CBR 650 is going. The indicators are also pretty well designed, very sleek, and the fit and finish looks quite good. Not like what you see on a Kawasaki, where the indicators are all rattling up on each and every bump, but they have a very strong feel to it. Good quality from Honda there. I don't think this windshield is adjustable. There are no knobs. This motorcycle is really capable of doing those track days, the way it is designed in terms of posture, and that is not my cup of tea, at least. That's a nice touch on the forks, the front forks with the Showa branding, looks quite good. The color, the fit and finish is also pretty good. It doesn't feel that there are any parts that have been put on as afterthoughts. So very well designed and fitted together in terms of components. That is the first ignition. The previous model of the 650R had a very old looking instrument cluster. This is all new, all modern stuff. With the digital console, that's a neat looking gear indicator right there. First gear, as you can see, on neutral now. You have a beautiful trip meter. The font, it has this flattish look, simplistic and elegant, typical of any Honda motorcycle. So the whole idea of me giving a first ride impression today is to talk about how the motorcycle feels in terms of the riding experience. I'm not going to talk about any technical details, any specs. All of that you can get on the Honda website, right? All I'm going to talk about is the experience and the sound. Of course, this one does not have the stock exhaust. It has a Two Brothers exhaust, which is making a beautiful growl right now. Just falling in love with this sound. There you go. The riding posture feels obviously a lot more committed than the Ninja 1000 that I've ridden a couple of times. But it is not as bad or as over committed as the RC390. So I would say a little easier on the shoulders and the hands. Of course, I'm just doing a test ride right now, so will not be able to tell you how it feels over a 100 kilometer or a 150 kilometer riding stretch. Now you get this clean stretch of road, and here it goes. It just breezed along. 100. Wow, that is fun. I'm on the sixth gear, and the tractability of this machine is beautiful. In terms of seat comfort, it is not very hard. The seat is not very hard. Of course, it is not meant to be as cushiony as an adventure tourer or a cruiser. One thing that is pretty odd about the button structure is the horn button. It needs to be pressed on the right side instead of the left side. Let me just show you this one. I need to press it on the right, which is a little unintuitive. So I am riding right now at 66 kilometers per hour and I am on the sixth gear, as you can see there. So the tractability of the motor is pretty good. I'm not sure how useful this windscreen will be, because right now I'm getting all the blast on my helmet. Of course, I'm not tucking in, and that is something that I don't know how to do. Let's talk about how it feels in traffic right now. I am not in a typical chock-a-block jam, but it is a stop-and-go affair, as you can see. And surprisingly, there is no heat that is coming from the engine. By no heat, I mean no excessive heat in comparison to the Versys 650, which is a parallel twin engine. So both these motorcycles, 650cc, this one being an inline four, should actually give out a little more heat. But kudos to the way they have redirected all the heat coming from the engine. I'm not feeling even an ounce of heat on my legs, even when I'm riding at 40 and 50. The gear shifts are very slick. I'm not hearing any sort of clutter or mechanical sound while shifting. And this motorcycle also comes with the Nissin brake calipers, similar to the ones that I have on my Versys 650 or the ones that you get on a Ninja 650 from Kawasaki. And the bite is quite similar. When I compare the two motorcycles, it has that typical bite that you associate with the Nissin brake calipers. Very progressive, nothing abrupt. So here we go. There's the sound for you again. Is quite good. Oh man, the punch is beautiful as well. The talkiness of this motor, the refineness, obviously coming from a parallel twin and riding an inline four, the level of refinement is palpable, and you can definitely feel how smooth the motor is. I was showing you guys how I am riding at 60 on the sixth gear. There are no jitters in the motor whatsoever. I'm just comparing it to the way the Z900 rides. The Z900 is nowhere near in terms of refinement if we compare it to this machine. I had ridden it for about 90 odd kilometers some months back while I was doing the sixth gear on a 60 to 65 kmph speed. It was having some sort of clutters and jerks that were coming through. I was hearing a couple of noises from the engine as well. Nothing of that sort in the Honda. Kudos to the levels of refinement of this machine. One of the worst times to do a test ride. Maybe I should do this again on a Sunday morning. In terms of riding posture, it is not super committed as you would expect from a sports bike. It's of course not a sports bike. It is not an all-out tourer as well, so something in between. If you want to really do 500 to 600 kilometers in a day, for me personally, I would not pick this motorcycle to do that sort of stuff. You can call it a comfortable version of a sports bike. That's what you can call it. am not very inclined to using the word sports tourer, because while this may fit the sports part to about 60 to 70%, from a touring part it is not more than 20%. So I would say it's more of a sports bike and less of a tourer. After riding it for about 8 kilometers, I'm already feeling some sort of pressure on my palms and a little bit on my shoulders as well. And maintaining this position, this one, for 150 kilometers at a stretch, that's what you need to do when you are touring, right? You can't stop every 50 kilometers. It can be a challenge on this machine. One thing that is really impressive about this machine is the way the engine has been made so tractable. Riding in the sixth gear again, 61 kilometers an hour, no jerks, all smooth, all refined. Another thing that is very sweet and beautifully designed is this new instrument cluster. Very simplistic design. You have this temperature gauge, you have this trip meter, a beautiful clock in the center, all digital console with the time at the top there. Nothing more fancy about it. I'm not sure how much functional this windshield is. I can definitely feel a lot of wind bashing onto my helmet because it's coming just above the camera on my helmet, hitting me on the helmet. So I think this would only be usable if you are riding all tucked in, which I am of course not. So in terms of riding experience, I would really rate this bike pretty high for what it's meant to do. Of course, it is not meant to be a 100% all out tourer, but I would say it is a motorcycle that you can easily use to ride 200 to 300 kilometers in a day without having a sore shoulder or palms.
So that was the first look of the newly launched Honda CBR 650R. I have ridden it for the first time, and apparently no deliveries have been made of this motorcycle from the Gurgaon showroom till now. So it's not on the roads anywhere to be seen. From a big bike's perspective, it might be a little small, but again, when you start riding this machine, especially with the Two Brothers exhaust that was installed on the test ride vehicle, it was making a beautiful symphony. The time that I chose to do the test ride was not perfect. I was doing a test ride on the National Highway 8 just behind me in the P car when the offices got over, and I was stuck in some traffic as well. But that gave me an opportunity to try out this machine and see how much heat it dissipates in traffic. And to my surprise, the heat dissipated was negligible. Trust me, we are in the peak summers right now in Delhi NCR right now, 41, 42 degrees Celsius in the day. I was riding this motorcycle in chock-a-block traffic and the amount of heat that was coming out was negligible. Some things that I didn't like were the way the rear end of the motorcycle is designed. It is not giving that premium feel. As I told, it is looking similar to what you get in what you see in a Dominar. The second thing is the pillion seat comfort is not great. I just sat on the pillion seat and it was not looking very comfortable, and there is no support as well. So it's going to be a very tricky situation if you try to take a pillion along with you on a long ride. To summarize, the last thing that I would like to say about this machine is I don't think it's a sports tourer. It's 85% a sports bike and 15% a tourer. What I mean by that is this is a motorcycle that you can easily ride for 200-300 kilometers in a day, not more than that. But if you're talking about serious touring, doing about 900-1000 kilometers in a day, then you will have a tough time here. Having a pillion with you, trying to tour on this machine is really going to be tough. So don't consider it if you're looking to do a lot of touring, you want to do Ladakh, Leh, Spiti, all that stuff. Try to find something else. This is not going to be the machine that will help you in those journeys. This is not a machine that would attract those 19 or 20 year olds. I mean, it does not have all that jazzy stuff. But if you are a mature rider and are looking for something which is really muted but has all the power when you need it, then this is a great machine to use. So that's it from my side. Hope you like this first look at the CBR650R. Let me know how you like the video. I would look forward to your comments, and don't forget to give this video a like and subscribe to this channel. Till next time, peace.